Hi, I'm Maxi Bayo, and together with my team, I will show you how to carry out the calibration of our chlorine dioxide sensor, MemoSense CCS50D. With this digital sensor, you can reliably measure chlorine dioxide in different water applications. Please remember, always wear your personal safety equipment before you start to work. Safety glasses, chemical-resistant gloves, and the coat. A fundamental principle of the chlorine dioxide calibration is the fact that the sensor remains in the process and a sample is taken out to be analyzed for the chlorine dioxide concentration. Analyzing the chlorine dioxide concentration of the sample is done offline with a colorimetric measurement according to the DPD method. Therefore, we need a portable photometer, cuvettes, and DPD reagents or a ready-made cuvette test. The reagents have a limited shelf life, so please check the expiry date before you start with the calibration. In this video, we will show you the procedure with the cuvette test. Important for the chlorine dioxide calibration is that the sensor readings are very stable. That means no drifts or unsteady values for at least 5 minutes. The following preconditions support best results for your calibration. The sensor must be fully polarized for at least 60 minutes. Sensor and medium must have stabilized to the same temperature. The flow must be constant and within the correct range. And the pH value must be in a range between pH 4 and 9. Now we start with the calibration procedure. For the determination of chlorine dioxide, we use a dedicated reagent. Depending on the manufacturer, this may be called DPD1 or DPDA, for example. First, we start the calibration procedure at the liquiline transmitter. Therefore, we press Calibration, choose Disinfection, then Slope, and come to sample calibration. Start the calibration and press OK. The transmitter checks if the stability criteria are fulfilled and stores the present value for a later adjustment. We continue with the next step in the calibration menu. Right after that, we take a sample out of the sampling line close to the CCA250 assembly. First, we start with a zero measurement at the photometer. For that, we fill 4 ml of sample with a pipette into the cuvette and mix it. The cuvette is inserted into the photometer to perform the zero adjustment. As a next step, we add the small tube called R2 into the cuvette and mix it with the sample by slowly turning it a few times. Ensure that there are no fingerprints on the outside of the cuvette or gas bubbles on the inside. Insert the cuvette into the photometer and determine the chlorine dioxide concentration. We continue with the liquiline by entering the chlorine dioxide value, which was shown on the photometer. Once the new slope was found to be within the allowed range, the transmitter allows you to store it in the CCS50D sensor head for adjustment. Now the calibration is finished. Wasn't that easy? Thanks for watching our video. Follow Andresen Hauser to see more of our productions. And hey, if this video was helpful, like it!